What? I gotta get out of here. Ugh.
Have you been? I've been waiting for you to take my spot.
Sorry. You can go. You can go now.
Yeah, clearly.
Like, I don't know what the big deal is. I was only late for Neumann Night Live.
It's Neumann Night Live. Starring Melanie Carmichael, Kula Gregor, Brian Forrest, Katie Moretti, Rob Foster, Nate Jones, Autumn Wilson, Brett Spicer, Kyrie Edwards, Shauna Devlin, Sierra Strickland, Kat Sullivan, Chad Johnson, Kathleen Poliski, with our special musical guest, two baseball players dipped in salsa. And here's your host, Sean McDonald and Patrick.
Hello and welcome to Neumann Night Live. My name is Sean McDonald. I am very honored to be hosting Neumann Night Live 3.0. But I have to tell you, I was not the first choice. I know, sad, right? I was actually more like the fourth choice. So last semester, we were supposed to do NKL, and Greccio got canceled because of snow. And Dr. Hamilton was our fearless leader. He was going to do it, and he couldn't make it down because he was too far away to drive. Then I said, I got this. I'll do it. I was the backup then, and I thought I'll be the backup again. And then I couldn't make it, so Brian Forrest did it. So now, get to this semester, Dr. Hamilton, we asked him again. He's like, I can't do it. Oh.
Hi, Sean.
What are you doing here?
Funny thing, Sean, I've never gotten an invitation to host this time. Do you know anything about that?
I have no idea what you're talking about. Yeah. I told them to email you.
Did you now?
Maybe I was supposed to send it?
So I'm starting to have my doubts about that snowstorm.
Anyway, I have no idea what you're talking about, but I'm glad to be hosting this party with our own Pat Fay as well. Come on in, Pat.
Hey, everybody. Hi, I brought cookies.
Pat,
how you doing?
We're
hosting.
We're hosting the party that's Neumann Night Live.
Yeah, I'm a good host. Emily knows that.
So it's finals week, and it means a lot of coffee, a lot of Red Bull, a lot of 5-hour energy is going to be drank this week.
A lot of good stuff.
A lot of people aren't going to be able to
poison them at all.
Actually take some naps, and Sean, sleep.
Sleep.
Sleep. Go rest up. Finals.
I should give him a minute.
Pat.
Did he ask anyone if
Pat,
he wanted anything to drink?
Pat, what are you doing?
Well, I'm still...
Pat.
I'm just being a good host.
Pat, we're hosting a TV show.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, we're hosting a TV show. We're not hosting a party.
Ooh, I have a better idea. Hold on. I prepared for this.
Okay. I have no idea what is going on right now. What are you hiding behind a curtain?
It's my segment.
Why do you have flowers?
Prune flowers. I love these. They're roses.
They're not roses.
So the bet.
They're definitely
yellow
not.
And with green leaves. I studied this.
Pat,
I know roses and I know poison ivy and I know these are roses.
This is not Martha Stewart.
It's great. I got this.
What
Sean?
Are you doing? Stop
Teaching
it. These aren't even roses. They're honeysuckle. And where did you find these things?
I came prepared.
No, you didn't. We are hosting New
now
Night
I'm embarrassed.
Live. It is a TV show. It is a. What
you know
are
what?
You doing?
I have turkeys in the oven. I'll be back. Everyone just hold tight.
We have a great show for you. We have two baseball players dipped in salsa. A lot of fun. Stay tuned. You are watching Neumann Night Live.
There are rules that I abide by. First one's coffee. It's black. It's so easy to get right. Just make sure you do it. I want it on my desk at 7:59 a.m., an hour and a half before I even consider doing anything. I need you to watch YouTube videos to make sure you inspire me and the work that I do, that you do, that we both do together. Your reward is to intern for the most well-known, smartest, kindest, I consider myself a nice person, on campus. But only one of you will be chosen.
Forget this, then.
Yeah. So back to what I was saying. Only one of you will be the intern.
I volunteer as tribute.
Shut up, cat piss.
Now go.
I got your drink. That's what you wanted.
This isn't a Pepsi Blue?
No, it's, yeah.
Try again.
You told me to get that.
You're eliminated.
No, I'm not. I'm not leaving. You can't make me leave. Make me leave.
Brett, make you do anything.
Are you
going to work
here? Are you going to pick me up and take me outside? I'm not leaving.
Here. I'm going to call HR. I don't know the number. I can look it up.
Your drink.
I'm still going to drink this. But it isn't a Pepsi Blue.
Look, I don't know what you want me to do. I come in here. I do everything that you
color
ask me
dye.
To do.
Anything. Blueberry soda. It's not that difficult.
Pet.
50 yards at all time, Katie.
Oh, hey, Brandon.
Hey, I was wondering.
Never wake me up.
No. I just had a quick question about the.
You're done.
Yeah, but let me finish.
It was nap time.
No, I understand what you're trying to say, but I got a quick question.
You see what I'm doing here?
Yeah, but I just had a quick question. I was just wondering.
See what I'm doing? I'm going to sleep.
Yeah, I was just wondering.
Done.
Should I just leave now?
Being so emotional. Stop the crying.
It's so scary.
I'm the only one in this relationship that is holding us together.
But Pat's so big. This is scary.
I have this challenge to win, and I have no time for you. Get yourself together.
This is story of a girl.
You keep doing work, and I'm singing to you, and you don't even respond.
You want me to do work?
Not when I'm playing the guitar. How many times do I have to say that?
I want to win this challenge. You never said that.
I'm self-conscious about my abilities here. I said, Sean, when I play the guitar, just act like you're listening. You're involved. You're invested.
Well, I can listen and do work. I do it with Pandora all the
time.
You're done. Oh, what do you mean I'm done?
You're out of the internship.
Are you kidding me?
You're not being accepted by Sean.
No. Are you seriously sitting here watching a movie right now? No.
For me.
Stop. It's bad enough I got you your own office. You're never in there. I can never find you. I find out you're putting work on students, and here you're doing it so you can sit and watch the Hunger Games on my time?
You're right. What was I thinking? I have no idea.
No. See, the buttering up and admitting that you're wrong thing doesn't work for me. You're fired, dude. Fired. Get out of here.
It was the not doing any work thing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And the exploiting students to do my work, wasn't it?
Child labor law is kind of a big deal.
Sorry.
Me too. See ya.
Na 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 na. Na 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 na.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Craigslist, the show where we bring desperate Craigslist classifieds and help them find a match. So, let's meet our contestants. First, Frederick Fim.
Hi, I'm Frederick Fim, and I'm here to be the next president, the president of student government, and I'm here to take over the world. I mean school.
Great. Jimmy.
Well, my name's Jimmy. I like babes, weights, mirrors. Did I say babes?
You said babes.
I like babes, and I'm just looking for a piece of eye candy for this arm candy.
Great. And last but not least, Lester Cunningham Jr. Jr.
I am Lester Cunningham Jr. Jr., born and raised in Mobile, Alabama. Huge Bama football fan. Forrest Gump, 94.
Mm-hmm. I don't think he actually went there.
No, he did. 94. Class of 94. You don't know nothing, all right?
Okay.
I'm just here looking for a little princess, you know what I'm saying?
All right, well, thanks, guys. So now let's meet our contestant who posted this classified, Shauna Devlin. How are you?
I'm doing very well. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. So tell me, why did you post this ad?
Well, I'm not quite ready to go back to Ireland, but my student visa is about to expire. I
seems pretty desperate. But so are our contestants. So let's start off with question number one. Frederick Fimp, when and where was your first kiss?
What? What kind of personal debate is this, Sean?
It's a dating game?
Shut up!
Yes, sir. Jimmy.
Well.
All right, Lester, what brings you here?
Well, I was at that Bama football game.
Right.
I met this girl. We started kissing. Mm-hmm. Then I found out her daddy was my uncle.
All right, next question. If you could be any animal, what would you be and why?
Well, I would have to pick a lion because they're the king of the world. Well, maybe the jungle.
Jimmy, how about you? Lester?
Largemouth bass, state fish of Alabama.
I would definitely agree, Shauna. So let's continue. Frederick, describe to Shauna your perfect first date.
Perfect date for me would be walk around the White House lawn, admiring just how power I have acquired at such a young age, since I'm going to be the youngest president of Pennsylvania ever, followed by a giant feast of nothing but most of the food of gold and be king of everything. Yeah. Power.
Okay. Unfortunately, Pennsylvania doesn't have a president. Jimmy, why don't you describe to us your perfect date?
What kind of question is this? I'm going to have to say it's going to have to definitely be the weight room. Mirrors. Selfies are king. Next question.
Okay. Lester. He's a great guy.
Yeah, he's all right. He's one of my favorites, you know. Are we going to be singing Friends in Low Places at the top of our lungs?
Lester, that's actually Garth Brooks.
You don't know nothing about no country music.
I think I know something. Nothing. I run a radio station.
What's the national anthem?
The Star-Spangled Banner.
Freebird.
All right, Lester, we get the point. You really love Skinner. So why, Frederick. Why, Frederick, should Shauna choose you?
What kind of question is that? Why wouldn't she choose me? I'm the most powerful human being ever that was born. I have power. Did I say I have power already? I can use my mind and use power. Woo-hoo.
Okay, Jimmy, why should Shauna choose you?
This is no competition. When she sees me, you can see me, and you know this is a great body right here. She's gonna realize these biceps, these deltoids, and this back are undeniable. I'm the one she wants. I'm the winner.
Okay. Lester, why should Shauna choose you?
Well, since I ain't got no job, I got a lot of time to dedicate to my little leprechaun. You know, we can watch Reese Witherspoon movies, Sunday NASCAR on my 17-inch black and white TV. If that's not romantic, what is? You know what I'm saying?
I really don't know how else that could be any more romantic. So, Shauna, the final question is for you. Which of these gentlemen are you going to choose?
I'm not choosing any of them. I'm getting out of here. My green card's not that important.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Another successful failure on Craigslist. And I'm your host, Sean McDonald, saying, watch what you click.
I've been contacted by my new client, LLC3RA Tiffany Connolly, about a mysterious case they're having. It seems a student is getting into the rooms every night. Nobody knows how or why. They hired me to find out. When residence life is beyond their abilities, which they often are, they need to call in a professional. They need to call in a person of true detective skills. They need to call in Sherlock.
Who are you?
Sherlock Holmes.
What are you doing here?
I'm here to solve a case.
Nice coat. Don't you know it's like a million degrees in here?
Are you a nursing major? You should be doing your research. I'd like to sign in the guest, please. It's an emergency.
What's your room number?
221B.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, let's go. Let's go.
There you are. I've been waiting for you.
Please elaborate. Oh, this is my colleague, Dr. Watson.
I don't recognize this student at all. I mean, and I know all my residents. I did see him 2 days ago in the common room reading a book, and he was at last night's social, but none of the RAs can catch him. Please, Sherlock. Watson, help me.
Do you hear that, Watson?
We've got a case. The game is on.
This name tag seems new, and the handwriting is all amateurish. A sophomore? No, freshman. Our first clue.
Where does that hallway lead?
Let's find out.
How curious. We seem to be in another building.
This is the freshman building, duh. Anyone can go from 2 to 3 or 3 to 2.
The freshman building. Yeah!
And we wonder why I don't stay the weekends.
Aha, a perfect fit. Now, which one is Paul?
Not just walk from LLC3 to LLC2. I understand there's a connecting hallway, but it's not okay for you to be walking back and forth when you're not signed in.
I know, I'm sorry. I'll get signed in next time I go over to LLC3. I didn't think it was a big deal, but I understand now.
As for you guys, it's nearly midnight, so you have a guest signed in, you're gonna have to sign them out. But thank you for solving the case, I really appreciate it.
Wait, what? We just solved the case, and this is how we get treated?
Rules are rules. I mean, you're more than welcome to hang out, but you just can't be in the dorms. I'm sorry.
Another case solved, my friend.
Connecting hallways. Elementary, my dear Watson.
Agreed, agreed. We should probably get back to LLC1 now.
This will be a lot simpler next year when we live together at the Bioni building. Many more mysteries to be solved there.
Like who sets off the fire alarms?
Yeah!
Ladies and gentlemen, this is two baseball players dipped in salsa. How's everyone doing today? First song we're about to play is called Wagon Wheel by Darius Rucker.
Down on the road and pray to God I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers. Hoping for Raleigh, I can see my babe at night. So rock on me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock on me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock on me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me.
Up in New England, I was born to be a swinger in an old time swing band. A baby picks guitar, I pick a banjo now.
Whoa, North Country winds keep getting me down. Lost my money playing poker, so I had to leave town.
But I ain't turning back to living that old life no more.
So wrong. rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel.
Rock me, mama, any way you feel.
Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain.
Rock me, mama, like a southbound train.
Hey, mama, rock me. To the south, down in Roanoke, I met a trucker out of Philly, had a nice long toke. But he's heading west from the Cumberland Gap to Johnson City, Tennessee. I gotta get a move on before the sun. I hear my baby calling my name, and I know that she's the only one. And if I die in rally, at least I will die free.
So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, and I way you feel.
Hey, mama, rock me.
Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain.
I wanna roll like a southbound train.
Hey, 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 mama, rock me.
Rockin' me.
Rock me. Mama, rock me.
Rock me.
Mama, rock,
rock me.
Thank you very much. The next song that we are about to play for everyone is called, it's a combination of Say What You Need to Say.
Funny, and if you went to the talent show, you've heard it before.
Yeah. I mean. Yeah. So there you go.
Your wasted honor, every little past frustration, and take all of your so-called problems, better put them in quotation. Say what you need to say, say what you need to say. 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 Say what you need to say.
I'm still walking like a one-man army. So funny with the shadows in your hair.
In your hair, in your hair.
I'll live another single moment's night. No one yet rebelled or up instead. If you could only say what you need to say. Say what you need to say. And say what you need to say. 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 Have no fear.
Have no fear.
Forgive our name. And have no fear. Have no fear for going over. No. Yes, you gotta know that.
Ooh.
In the end, it's better to say too much. Than never to say what you need to say again.
Say what you need to say. Say what you need to say. Say what you need to say. Say what you need to say.
Say what you need to say.
Say
what you need to say. Say what you need to say.
Say what you need to say.
Ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum, da. Ba-da-dum, da na 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 na. Ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum, da. Ba-da-dum, da na 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 na. Salsa, say what you need to say. Salsa, say what you need to say.
Say it.
Salsa, say what you need to say.
Say what you need to say.
She's a good girl. Loves her mama.
loves Jesus. America too. She's a good girl. Crazy about Elvis. Loves horses. And a boyfriend too. Oh. Free falling now. I'm free falling now. I'm free falling now. I'm free falling now. I'm free falling and I'm free falling and I'm free falling and I'm free falling and I'm. It's a long day living in Reseda, and there's a freeway running through the yards. Cause I'm a bad boy, cause I don't even miss her. And I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart. Now I'm free falling, I'm free falling.
Say what you need to say.
Say what you need to say.
Woo! Thank you so much.
Will be the best it's ever been. Formation, not just development, but formation. It's time a new idea rises, so I call on the best.
Oh, Eric and Melanie from our Division of Campus Ministry. How's it going?
This is exciting.
This is exciting. It's time to change.
Core team, core team, core team.
Hey! Yeah, I just ran a CrossFit.
Kind regards. Welcome, Frank and Tiffany, from our most pleasant division of student affairs.
Oh, Brian Forrest, director of Neumann Media.
Four parts, one club. Club of the year.
I brought you all here today to do a flash mob. Bishop!
What was that?
Oh dear, Bishop is a game that I played in my youth. The last person to respond to the Bishop signal loses. So basically, Tiffany, you have to book the room and email maintenance for the flash mob.
I don't see this in the Constitution.
Bishop.
You should just stick to the core team song.
Oh, okay.
So I invited you here today to brainstorm new ideas for the flash mob. I'll give you a few minutes to see what you come up with.
Hey,
Melanie. What do you have?
Well, I was thinking collaborate, organize, reflect, quarantine. Yes, I told you, yes.
What was that?
Go on retreat, you'll find out.
And Frank, what did you come up with?
Well, I was thinking that we could call it the storm.
So my thoughts are that each organization can fill out the particular documents found on the website through student government's guidelines found in Robert's Rules, Section D, Part C, Line 417, and really work this out. Don't forget to put it on social media. Hashtag I love hashtags. Hashtag director of student government. Hashtag from Rosemont to Neumann. Hashtag food for thought. Hashtag Tiffany woke up like this.
Brian, I know you're already super busy because you run 4 clubs, but do you have anything to contribute?
Well, since you all run 1 club and I run 4, I figured that I would videotape it, broadcast it, stream it live on the air, while simultaneously posting movies about teamwork on YouTube.
That's great!
It's already done. I already had YouTube do it while they were doing their stupid handshake.
Bishop!
Yeah.
Okay, Mel, you lost Bishop. So you're in charge of coffee, refreshments, and of course, Neumann's favorite email blast.
Oh. I gotta go.
Bishop! Brian, you are in charge of getting the volunteers. All of them.
I already set up a Google Doc. It's done. 4 parts, 1 club. Howdy.
I have to go too.
Why?
We all do. We booked the room from 3 to 4 and it's 4:01.
But what about the storm?
The storm's over. Cause there's only one team, core team, time to go.
Let it go, let it go. Can't hold back anymore.
All right, Sister Alexina students, you're in charge of all the music. It's time to make this flash mob great.
To witness is a recorded AA meeting that shows you a glimpse of a very real addiction in today's society. We ask that you view this with an open mind, as people you know may be suffering from the addictions you are about to witness.
Welcome to AA, also known as Applications Anonymous. Remember that everyone in this room has went through some sort of phone application addiction, as I can see you are going through now. A little bit about myself. I was addicted to Angry Birds for 6 months. I lost my job and 65 pounds. I look great, but I'm sad. But through the help of these AA meetings and my sponsor, Steve Wozniak, we're still good friends, I have been addiction-free for 6 years, 7 months, 4 weeks, 3 days, and counting. That's pretty good. Enough about myself. Who wants to start this meeting first?
I guess I'll start. Hi, y'all. My name is Valencia Walden.
That is a beautiful name.
Thank you. That's the name my mama gave me, but she mistakenly gave me the name Stacey Mae Williams, but I didn't like that name. So when I turned 18, I legally changed it to Valencia Walden, because those are my two favorite Instagram filters. I just felt an instant connection with those filters. They know me better than anyone. I lost all my friends. They got embarrassed of me.
Why? Like what?
Well, it started off with the normal pictures, like the food we ate when we went out, the nights out at the club, when we got our nails did. But then it started to get a little out of control. I started taking pictures of everything. The dare I hit last week, the super slink weighted glass, everything, and the hobos over, even on the street. After I had to get bailed out of jail the third time, it was over.
Why were you in jail?
Oh, stupid stuff. Like people saying I was following them in private places. But I wasn't. If you're going to leave your door unlocked, I'm going to come in. I mean, I'm going to photograph all your Instagrammable moments. It's not my fault your baby is adorable.
I understand your pain. I, too, have been through this application addiction. So, what are you doing to help yourself?
Well, I don't know, but I think coming here is a good start.
All right, not too bad. So, who wants to go next?
That was like a 5.3. Sorry, my name is Candy.
Candy? Hello, Candy.
All right, anyway. Yeah, and it's Brooke with two E's, by the way. Okay, thanks. I like long walks on the beach, mani-pedis, trips to Starbs, and froyo with my BFFs. I'm looking for a man over 6 feet tall who's honest and compassionate and who loves cats.
Okay, Candy, it's nice to meet you. But how did your addiction start?
Well, I knew I was hot from a young age, of course. I mean, look at me. Then Hot or Not came out and I was like, OMG. Now everybody can know how hot I really am. It was a real struggle before, let me tell you.
Why is that?
Well, no guy wants to date a girl named Gertrude Steinwinzer.
Would you like me to call you Gertrude?
Ew, 2.4? No, I would not like you to call me Gertrude. Would you like me to call you annoying? Because you are.
I would actually prefer if you called me Susan Bennett.
Oh my gosh, I don't care. Anyway, where was I? Oh yeah, my horde name. How am I going to get any likes with a name like Gertrude? I mean, come on. Candy with an I is way hotter than Notter, y'all. I really love Hot or Not. I met my boyfriend 4 hours on there, and we're so into each other. He texts me like 100 texts per hour. We're even texting right now. It was love at first sight, let me tell you.
That is not love. Love is a strong, positive emotion or a beloved person used as terms of endearment or a source of, or a zero, score zero it's in tennis or squash.
Let me guess, you're addicted to Siri.
You are correct. You must be a relative of Sherlock Holmes.
OMG, hashtag rude.
Hello. We haven't heard from you yet.
Hi, my name is JC Handler, and I'm addicted to Twitter.
Cool.
Yeah. I'm failing English class because all my answers are 140 characters or less. My professor always take punch off me for abbreviating words, like ARD and NVM. I'm always up to date and know what's trending. I've got kicked out of class for constantly giving up trending updates.
Sounds like you have a pretty good grasp on how this addiction has affected your life. Well, how do you plan to get back on track?
Back on track? Back on track? Man, I haven't been this much on track since I started walking. This is exactly where I want to be. School, family, friends, they're all distractions from my main true goal.
Oh, child, what's your real goal?
To be verified.
Of course.
That's so hot. Like smoking hot.
The probability of you being verified is highly unlikely due to the fact you're not a celebrity, nor have you been done anything significantly important.
That's it. That's it.
Siri.
I've had enough with you. All you do is try to smash everybody's dreams, smashing everybody's goals. Like, what's your problem? All you want to do is live.
It's all right, man. It's all
right. It's all right. Calm down. It's okay.
I'm sorry.
How's your struggle?
I haven't played Candy Crush in over 2 days now. I'm starting to realize that this addiction has a true hold on my life. ever since I was a little kid, all I would do is buy Jolly Ranchers and go home in my basement and grab a hammer and just start smashing them and smashing them and smashing them into their little tiny pieces. So tasty. My name's Stan Lomboy, but you can call me Crush for short. Ever since Candy Crush came out, I realized that my life has been so complete with this game, but it's only been tearing apart all my friends and family and all my relationships. Whenever I lose, I just want one more move, and I'll pay that extra 99 cents. And I do it so often that they don't even ask me anymore, because I realize that at a very young age, never give up, never surrender. But now, my mom calls me and she says, "Share one, you can't have a drafted." And I tell her, "Mom, don't worry about it, Mom, I'll figure it out." What am I going to do? I really am so lost.
It's a lot of heavy information. So how do you plan to get everything back on track and pay back that money?
I'm going to start a rap label. Hey. It's going to be called Crushing Them.
Oh, let me tweet that. Crushing Them. Yeah.
My new single, all I do is crush.
Crush, crush, baby.
It'll be perfect.
Violation of rule number one, no phones in application anonymous.
There she goes again.
Jeez.
Yeah, man, yeah. You got the lives ask for? All I need is 5, man. I'm on level 187. Yo, if you can do this for me, I'll hook you up. All right, tell Bibi what's up. Crush on, player. Crush on.
That guy sounds mysterious. Who is he? Does he have a profile on Hot or Not?
No.
Does he follow me yet? He should. I am hot.
This dude's low key.
All right, how about we start wrapping up? So, let's go around and share what we've learned today.
Well, excuse me. Well, I learned I'm not alone in this circle of addiction. Now, possibly we have some new Instagram followers at ValenciaXOXO Walden.
Cute response, Valencia. Not. Anyway, I learned today that Twitter addicts are cuter than I thought they were. How
Crush,
you doing?
What did you learn today?
Okay.
How about you, Susan?
Judging by the responses that I've just heard, there has been no substantial progress here during this meeting, and I will definitely not be coming back.
Thank God. Thank you, yes. Jesus.
Yes. Now let's all go out and tweet. Get something to eat.
Yeah. But wait, y'all. Who's there in the corner looking all sad?
I don't know. I'll go ask. Excuse me, sir.
I'm Tom, and this is my space. Whoa. Get out of my space! Why are you in my space? I tried to get friends to like my space, but then they won't join me. Get out of my space! I reserve this room.
Christmas and Joseph. No!
Get! This is my space.
Bye, Tom.
Bye.
So have you seen Katie lately? I've been trying to follow her schedule and I just can't seem to find her. I really want to ask her to formal.
This is exhausting. Hey, Rob.
Oh, hey, Kula.
Do you want to go to formal with me?
Ugh. Kula asked me to formal and I felt really bad because she's not as beautiful, amazing, just a great personality, as smart as Katie. And I really couldn't find Katie, so I'm gonna have to say yes to Kula and then find Katie at the dance.
Sure?
Okay, great. I was thinking about wearing my black dress. It's kind of short and tight or whatever, but it has studs on the shoulders. And then I was thinking about wearing my shoes. They're gold and orange and they have studs too. And I think it'd be really great if we went together. You know, like a lacrosse thing? Wouldn't it be so...
I'm that flight that you get on. DJ, hit it!
Welcome to the real world, sunshine.
Where am I?
You're in the hospital. Doctors say you fainted a broken heart.
Really?
No, you're in the nursing wing. You just fainted. You're fine. Seriously. We just got back from formal, and you were serenading Katie, and you fainted.
Where is Katie? Where is Katie?
All our friends are outside. They're just wondering where you are. They're wondering that if you're okay or not.
Katie!
No.
Katie!
Rob, they're going to put you in the mental ward if you keep doing that. So I'll go get our friends, okay?
Rob fainted at the formal, and we don't really know what's going on. Like, Rob came out of nowhere, and, like DJ hit it, and all this crazy stuff was going on dancing.
No.
Wait, I'll be right back. I'll let you know later.
Oh, my God.
All right, give him room.
Rob, I was so worried about you.
Rob, we were all worried about you. We need to stop fighting over these SD cards, going through people's bags. You know, it's our last semester here. We're all graduating soon. So we should just enjoy each other now because we're one big happy family at the end of the day.
Are you even on the executive board?
And can you not interrupt me like that again? Thanks.
I'm just kidding. I'm sorry.
Katie.
Rob, I really had no idea you felt that way about me. And the fact that you wrote that song meant the world to me.
Kula went on to be a successful model in New York. She hasn't talked to Rob since the incident. Pat went on to marry his longtime fiance, Emily. He still works at Neumann, and he continues to draw and ignore the attention of new college girls that walk into the TV station. He and Brian plan to go out for the lacrosse team when they both start graduate classes. No one really knows Nancy. We don't really know why she followed us around. I didn't have her number to see what she's been up to since graduation. Well, I hope she graduated. Rob moved on from college and became a high school math teacher and lacrosse coach. He and Katie are still going strong, and they plan on moving in together soon. Katie has moved on to be a sideline reporter for the 76ers. She eventually plans to have her own talk show in New York and hopes her and Rob will move there eventually. Kat worked her way quickly through the ladder on Comcast Sportsnet. When their producer fainted in the middle of a Flyers game, she jumped in and directed the rest of the broadcast. The vice president of Comcast decided to keep her there. Mel worked at a magazine for a while before her production career took off. She's out in California now, working as a freelance producer for different companies. Well, Brian isn't graduating. He still has a whole other year. He plans on becoming best friends for life with Pat since he's losing all of his current friends because they're graduating. He hopes one day to open a production company with everyone and get company cars so they don't have to pay for insurance.
And I'm Kathleen Poliski, the creator of the Media Club. Thank you so much for sticking with us this season. It's truly been a blast, and I'm really sad to see all of us leave. But our very own Brian Farris will be taking over next semester, so please stay tuned.
This is a bad time right now. I'm trying to do my radio show. I am sick of you people interrupting my show.
First, in today's news.
Kula, what are you doing?
Oh, KP, you're back?
Yeah, this is awkward. I've been back for 4 months now. So why are you doing the Neumann update?
I always do the update now when you left, but I guess we can do it together.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, like I was saying, first in today's news, a 17-year-old from Maine took a selfie with a squirrel while walking through the woods. Frightened by the phone's noises, the squirrel proceeded to attack him by climbing up his shirt, then clinging to his back. He then threw himself onto the ground and to scare the squirrel away. The 17-year-old next stop is a college in Alaska, and I'm looking forward to seeing the polar bear selfies.
What a wonderful story, Kula.
Thanks, KP.
Yeah, okay. A man from Providence was arrested last week from using a potato that was wielded in the shape of a gun to hold up a convenience store. He shouted out, "Fries! I mean, freeze! Give me your money."
That was funny.
Thanks.
Spain is in the process of possibly passing a law which would make children under the age of 18
in households to legally have to have co-responsibility in caring for their home and performing in household tasks regardless of age or gender. Could you imagine if the USA followed that? I would, my college loans, I'd be living at home until I'm 25. Thank goodness I'm over 18.
Wow, lazy.
What?
Whoa, crazy! Anyways, Austin Dennison from Ohio took his 89-year-old great-grandmother to his senior prom because she had never been asked to one herself when she was in high school. It's truly an inspirational story and gives me hope that I still have a chance to finally get asked to prom.
You never went to prom?
No, do you have a problem with that?
No, I just, it's really sad.
Okay, I'm not really appreciating your time
at this
moment. I don't
appreciate your
time.
So I don't.
This is rough.
Hey, Pat.
I have a way to settle this.
Where'd you come from?
Sing off.
What? All right, Let me.
Sing off, cooler. There's no time.
You know, I have to prepare myself if you want this to be perfect, right?
You're losing points.
I'm gaining points, Pat.
All right, I did not bring a sweatshirt.
I'm ready.
Good job, cool.
Thanks.
Good job.
Microphones, please.
Who won, Pat?
That was too close. Tiebreaker.
Oh my God.
Tiebreaker.
Lights, please.
So who won?
Well, that's been this week's Neumann
Update. Are you kidding me?
Bye, guys.
When Pat was in the Knights Cafe, I kept on seeing him look at me while he was ordering a wrap. Do you think he was ordering a chicken tender wrap? Because he was totally texting me all about it last night. And I don't know if he thinks I'm a wrap expert, so, like, what do you think? Do I look like a Knights Cafe addict? How did that girl even come? Do you see her? She's so barbaric, and that backpack is so big. Who studies? I'm not even in the radio station. Why does the DJ keep on playing Chumbawamba? Before we leave the night, can I get a fountain soda? I really need one. But first...
let me take a selfie.
Can you help me pick a soda? I don't know if I should go with Diet Sprite or Diet Pepsi. I want to be healthy. What should my caption be? I want to be Franciscan. How about living for Jesus? Hashtag praise. I only got like 10 likes in the last 5 minutes. Do you think I should take it down?
Let me take another selfie.
Wait, pause. Pat just liked my selfie. What a stalker. Is that girl for real over there? Yeah, the one buying all the salads. That's so expensive. That girl is such a health freak. She definitely bought all those with her nice points. Who doesn't go to the nice cafe? Okay, let's go to class. Oh no, I forgot to print my paper. Oh wait, never mind. I did. Let's go upstairs. There's no one at this class. Do you think it's canceled? Oh my god, Pat just texted me. Should I meet him after the class? I guess I took a good selfie.
Well, that's our show. Thank you so much to two baseball players, Dipped in Salsa. Let's give them another round of applause. So a lot of hard work goes into planning Neumann Night Live. And three semesters ago, it was nothing more than an idea that came out of somebody going up to Saturday Night Live and saying, I think we could do this. I think we should do this. And what you just saw was months of hard work. So I'd like to bring in the entire cast that just did it and the seniors who are back in the control room. Can everyone please come back onto the camera? Hurry. It is not easy to put on a live production, and you can see how many people it takes to do what you just watched for the last hour and 5 minutes. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all of your support this year. Thank you to our seniors who are graduating. We will miss you very dearly, but we promise to keep everything you have started here going, and we will make you proud. I'm Sean McDonald.
Pat Fay.
This has been Neumann Night Live.